This tiny dude is a proton. Is it a particle or is it a wave? You have probably heard this debate about a gazillion times. Well, it turns out almost everything you have been told about particles is kind of a BS. So let's see what is really going on. These two are the proton's best friends, the electron and the neutron. They love hanging out together. Toss in a few more and you have just built an atom. But wait a second, we may have a problem. Because protons and electrons have opposite charges. And so they should attract each other, right? Kind of like you attract ridiculously complicated science. But if they attract, why don't they just collide and explode? Some random genius was like, yo, what if electrons orbit the protons, just like Earth orbits the Sun? Brilliant idea. Except it's actually a terrible idea. Because when an electron moves in circles, it emits light. And that uses up some of its energy. So an orbiting electron would lose speed and then fall into the proton anyway. Congratulations, we have just solved, well, nothing at all. And this is exactly when the science bros realized that they were missing the bigger picture. Because it turns out that particles are not tiny solid balls. They are something way more bizarre. But what exactly? And that was when this guy appeared. They called him Schrödinger. He showed up with one equation to rule them all, quantum particles. Okay, that's too many weird symbols for my taste. So let's do it other way. Imagine a tiny solid ball, but this time spread it across space. Now you have a tiny little cloud. Yeah, that's right. A particle is never really at one place. It isn't just here or here. It is sort of everywhere. Basically, the gods said, let's play dice with the universe and made their existence uncertain. Bright spot? Yeah, existence is likely. Dark spot? No, nothing to find here. But this uncertainty isn't just some mathematical trick. It's not only that we don't know where the particle is. The particle itself doesn't know that either. That's what particle really is. It's just the cloud of uncertainty. In our world, we can predict how something moves exactly. Easy. But in quantum world, we instead predict how the cloud of uncertainty moves. And stop. After 1 second, the cloud got exactly here. Completely predictable. Now, let's make it more interesting. This time, we will smash the electron at the wall with a tiny door. Looks weird, right? It's because electron moves like a wave. And this is what waves do. If you don't believe me, just look at these ocean waves. As they hit this gap, they start spreading in circles. Now, let's smash that small cloudy bastard again, but at a single proton. That's some crazy shit, right? Okay, one last experiment, but this time forget the violence and just put the electron gently near the proton. It will not fall in, it just wiggles around. Give it a little more time and the electron will settle into a stable shape, like this, this, or this. You may know them as atomic orbitals. So somehow, when electron behaves like a wave, it becomes stable. It does not fall into the proton. But why exactly? Don't waves just travel endlessly? So how come that the electron's cloud is just chilling there? Well, imagine a vibrating guitar string. It's a wave that is trapped between two fixed points, the ends of the string. It vibrates in place, but does not travel anywhere, because, well, because it physically can't. Now, just apply the same idea to the electron. Its cloud of uncertainty is held in place not physically, but by the proton's electromagnetic pull. It creates sort of an invisible wall. The electron can't escape, but cannot fall in either. It may be a little bit more abstract, but it uses the same wave logic, so the end result is the same. So now you may be thinking, okay, great, particles are waves, end of story. Except that's just the beginning, because quantum waves are not just casual waves, like the ocean waves. The equations that describe them are somewhat similar, but not the same. Plus quantum waves love messing with anyone who tries to look at them. And this is where most quantum confusion comes from. Imagine an electron minding its own quantum business. Then suddenly it touches something big, non-quantum, like a detector, or even just a grain of sand. And that's exactly when everything changes. The wave kind of collapses, and suddenly we just see one thing at one place. Just like your will collapses whenever you want to subscribe to a decent YouTube channel. So basically, we can never see the wave itself. Only a collapsed leftover, which we usually call a particle. And this happens every time you look, no exceptions. So what in the quantum hell is going on? Well, obviously, another genius appeared and said, "Oh guys, look, electron is both a wave and a particle. It's a particle when we are looking and a wave when we are not looking." You know, the wave-particle duality concept. You may have heard of that. Except, it is kind of a nonsense, because the particle aspect is just an illusion. The actual problem is that we are dealing with something so tiny that just trying to look at it messes it up completely. And so, when we want to look at a quantum wave, it changes from being spread out to being super localized. But it's still a quantum wave. It's just that its cloud of possibility shrinks down. That's all there is to it. And right after the collapse, the quantum wave continues traveling just like a wave. So what looked like a particle was just the quantum wave, pretending to be a particle. One question remains though. Why the wave even collapses? Yeah, nobody really knows. But we do know one thing for sure. It's not just about us looking. It's about the boundary between tiny quantum world and our big world. At some point, these two worlds have to align to one consistent thing. And that's where weird things happen. Alright, now that you've got some quantum muscle, let's solve the most misunderstood experiment of quantum physics. The double slit experiment. It's the experiment that shows that the electrons are sometimes waves and sometimes particles, depending on what you do. So what's the truth? The experiment is pretty simple. We take a single electron and smash it against two tiny doors. That's it. So what is going to happen? Now that you know that the electron is a quantum wave, it makes complete sense. The electron's cloud goes through both of these two doors. At each door, a new wave is formed. Then these two waves interfere, just like water waves would. This new funky wave continues traveling until it reaches the detection plate. Since that is a big non-quantum thing, the wave collapses randomly at one of the bright spots. Do this a million times, recording where each electron lands, and you will see the famous interference pattern. This was really done by the science bros, and it proves that electrons indeed behave like waves. Now, here's the twist. We add a detector to one of the slits. You may have heard that this forces the electron to act like a particle, because in this case, the interference pattern disappears. But guess what? We can still explain what happens using only quantum waves, no need for particles. So let's place another detector behind the doors. In this case, if we repeat the experiment a million times, we will just see two spots. It looks like the electron is now behaving like a particle, not a wave. But let's have a closer look. When we measure the electron as it passes through, it will collapse the wave. So now there is no second wave to interfere with, which means that the wave just continues to travel on its own. And when it finally arrives at the detection plate, it will again collapse at a random bright spot. But this time, there is no interference because there was no second wave. So this experiment doesn't prove that the electron suddenly started acting like a particle. It just means that the wave lost its chance to interfere with itself. So believe it or not, everything can be explained using only quantum waves. We don't really need standard particles. So yeah, I hope that makes sense. And also doesn't. Because if it all made perfect sense, I would have nothing to make videos about. If your brain is still intact, locate your mouse and hit that glorious subscribe button. See you next time.